Lord God, as we bow our heads and lift up our hearts. Father God, as we come in the wonderful name of Jesus, Lord God, we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God, for another day, another opportunity to be in the land of the living one more time. Father God, we give you glory. Lord God, we thank you right now, Father God, as we come, Lord God, to come study your word, to come feast, to come dine, to hear what you have got to say to us, oh Lord God. We thank you in advance for what you're going to do, what you're going to say. Holy Spirit, we invite you in. We just invite you in to come in and invade our situation, invade our homes, invade our minds, bodies, and spirit, man. In the name of Jesus, do whatever you need to do. Come down in this temple, oh God, to take whatever you've got to do, Lord God. We thank you in advance that you're going to do a complete work in the name of Jesus. And we said amen.
Amen.
Bibles, you need your sword. You should always pack your 66. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, I feel like the Spirit.
Yes,
the
Lord. And amen, amen. Yes, Lord.
You're like, I don't know what's going on. You gotta hold on.
Yes, Lord.
You gotta hold on. I tell you, it's just in any given moment, the Lord comes.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, the word of the Lord God, today, he called the Bahaya. We're gonna go down to the prophet Isaiah.
Amen.
How many of you like to go to the prophet Isaiah? I like to go to the prophet Isaiah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most times, when you're turning, see, people don't realize the prophet Isaiah, he had a wife. Come on now.
Amen.
Amen. And his wife was a prophetess.
Amen.
All right now. Isn't that a beautiful thing?
Yes, Lord. Yes. Amen.
I know a lot of times we don't hear about it, but a lot of these men and women of God, they have spouses too.
Yeah. Amen.
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 Yes, Lord.
I'm saying that to Lord. I'm trying to encourage someone up in here. Yes, Lord. I'm trying to encourage you now. Come on now. Come on now. Thank you, Lord God. If God's going to use him, God's going to use you too. Yes. If God's going to use her, he's going to use you too. Yes. And you together in this thing.
Amen.
Come on, trying to encourage somebody up in here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. The word that the Lord God has, very, very simple. It's a three-letter word. And it is way. W-A-Y.
Wow.
Way.
Wow.
Way.
Yeah.
Yes. It's called way. Yes. W-A-Y. Mm-hmm. And you're like, oh, that's such a three-letter word. So simple. Mm-hmm. Way is defined as a method or style. The manner of something being done.
All right. Lord.
It's a certain way about the Lord. See, he's not like any other God.
Come on.
He's a big God.
Hallelujah.
Woo! Is it, can you imagine God has style?
Amen, amen.
He has a way of doing it.
Yes, Lord.
That no one else can do.
Amen.
The title of today's message is Waymaker.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but surely enough, He's a way maker. He's a way maker. Beautiful.
Yes.
I know what the boss man is saying.
Yes.
But he said, I have a Begin our reading. I want you to stay focused on Isaiah 43, 15. Hear what the Lord God is saying. When you're there, say amen.
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 Isaiah 43, 15. Amen. The word of the Lord God says, I am the Lord, your holy one. Yes. The creator of all Israel, your king.
Amen.
Thus said the Lord, who makes a way
today,
a way in the sea, and a path through the mighty waters. Pause right there. There's your verse right there. That's where the message comes from. Right there in verse 16. He said, thus said the Lord, who makes what? A way in the sea, and the path through the mighty waters.
Yes.
Jesus. The Lord God said that, you know, I come to make a way for you. You must understand that whenever God decides to make a way for you, before you do anything, you got to recognize who he is.
Yes.
Oh, how powerful that he is.
Amen.
He said, I am the Lord, your Holy One.
Amen.
That's what I keep saying, and I'm going to continue to shout it from the mountaintop. Stop putting God like a small God. Stop weighing God up and get some baby gods. Because he's a big God.
Amen.
Capital G-O-D.
Yes. Amen.
Hey, almost a, not the little G-O-D.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
Capital G-O-D.
Amen.
He's a big God. And I'm saying that because at times, whenever we go through things, sometimes we like to put him in the little G-O-D. We put him there because he hadn't done what we wanted him to do when he told him to do it. But we told him, oh, you're getting there. But we told him. And all of a sudden, he's like, oh, well, I love God. And the Lord God said, no. We're talking about the Alpha and the Omega.
Amen.
The beginning and the end.
Amen.
You're talking about the creator, the Holy One.
Amen.
The one who created every fiber of
yes,
your
being.
Yes, Lord. You're wondering how God says, I know every hair on your head.
Preach it, Pastor.
He said,
yes.
And even though they may get a little sprinkling of the grace, he said, I love you too.
Too.
Yes, Lord.
And a lot of people don't like this, but baby, let's call some wisdom.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let the sprinkles come on.
Yes, Lord.
Come on up here. Hallelujah. Be proud about that.
Amen.
Hey, that's some prayer right there. Come on.
Amen. Amen.
But the Lord God said, I even admonish that.
Jesus.
I want you to understand that God says in verse number 16, thus said the Lord, who makes a way in the sea,
oh my God,
a path through the mighty waters. Yes, we got some mighty waters, people of God.
Oh.
Everybody got some mighty waters.
Yes.
I don't know what your mighty waters are. I don't know what your sea is.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But we all got some. Look at
Amen.
Verse 6 said, away in the sea. You see, you got a sea and I got a sea.
Amen.
Your sea may be bankruptcy.
Amen.
Come to me now.
Amen. First
your sea may be divorce.
Amen.
Your sea may be a sickness. Come on.
Yes, Lord.
Your sea may be a rebellious child.
Amen.
Talk to me.
Amen.
Your sea may be a troubled marriage. I don't know
yes,
what your
Lord.
Sea is.
Yes.
I don't know what you're saying, but everybody got a sea.
Yes.
Everybody, that means everybody in here. If you're above the age of 5 years old, you got some work on your hands.
Amen.
Amen.
And then maybe even two.
Amen.
You're cheering small.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Come on now.
Yes.
That means everybody has something. The Lord God said, but I want you to know I will make a way
Amen.
In the sea. You see, mighty waters is when it get a little bit heavier, mm-hmm. people of God. Mighty waters, you know, oh, that helped me. And then the Holy Spirit taught me that. He said, your sea is things that are external.
Okay.
Bankruptcy, divorce, corrupt marriage. But he said, mighty waters, that's internal. Sickness, illness, mental illness, addictions.
Whoa.
Oh, and those things that are internal. I said, well, help me, Holy. So see, the sea is external, but mighty waters are internal. Things that your spirit man, your mind, your mentality. You see, some of us, you're looking well on the outside, but you got some mental problems.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Out and amen. You're like, well, no. Some of you just about this much from being committed. Come on now.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yeah, I'm just telling the truth. You know,
amen.
Whenever you go through something, you... I got some wrong people up in here. You're like, oh, that's not me. You ain't lived long enough. Wait a minute.
Preach it, Pastor.
Keep on living this world.
Preach it, Pastor.
Keep on living. You're like, this could
have come
out. You're like, it's funny about you. You need to commit because you're not talking about the loss of your mind.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
Come on now. We like that pressure
Amen.
Cooker.
Yes,
put
Lord.
That pressure, put that meat in there.
Yes, Lord.
Before you know it.
Yes, Lord.
You're like, Lord, have mercy. My God. And don't let nobody open that when you're not supposed to open
Jesus.
If anybody know anything about a pressure, open up some steam whenever you're not supposed to open it.
Amen.
You're going to find out what you're going to have when you're going to get burned, baby, burned.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not going to be pretty. You ain't going to be like, oh, no. You'll be like, ah. I'm here to tell you, but that's how we all
Amen.
Sometimes.
Amen.
Well, that pressure cooker. You're like, wait a minute, don't touch my nose.
Amen.
Don't mess with my nose. Because I'm
Yes, Lord.
I got something cooking and you don't
Amen.
Open
no.
it. Hey, come on now. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I'm talking about the Lord God. He said, make a way. I wanted you to understand that God said he's a way maker.
Amen.
In all in your sea as well as your mighty water. But you need to understand, as God says, that I will make a way for you in the midst of all of your troubles, your external issues, and your internal issues. He said, I will make a way. He didn't say that you had to call somebody else and they was going to make a way.
All right, Lord.
He said, the Holy One of Israel said, and I'm here to tell you, like, well, why every time we talk, we hear about trusting in the Lord? Because he's the one you're supposed to trust.
Amen, amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says, some trust in horses, some trust in chariots, but I put my trust
in the Lord.
He said, you know what, in case you didn't realize, you know, horses got to be led by a bit.
Amen.
Bit by bit.
Amen.
Giddy up and go. They don't like to be led. You got to, come on, yeah.
Yes, Lord.
Bit by bit. You got to be led by it. You got to pull the reins sometimes. But the Lord God said, well, when you trust in the Lord, you ain't got to worry about that little bit. You know, whenever you give God something to help me, Holy Ghost, you know he's preaching up
here. Amen, amen.
You know he's pouring it
Yes,
out.
Lord,
and
amen.
I'm putting it down and I'm picking it up.
Yes, hey, Lord, yes.
Yes,
Lord.
Oh, I got that down. Bit by bit.
Amen.
See, as he's pouring it out, he's saying, you know what? That's how it is. See, people can't handle everything that you're trying to give to them. You see, we're trying to give them a whole overload. You're like, well, can I help? Oh, the Lord God said, no, you can't do that.
Amen.
But see, with the Lord, you can give it all to him.
Amen,
you
amen.
All your cares
amen.
Upon the Lord
yes,
because he cares for thee. Us, we got to give him a bit by
my
bit.
Okay.
Because you give him a little bit, then sometimes you ask the racks, and sometimes they're like, not that brother over there. No. You got that going. And then they start bucking. horse is somewhere in my
life. Yes, Lord.
In case you ain't running, yes, I got a horse, I got a horseman. Come on now. Uh-huh. You know, we know about that bucking and all mess around. You get a horse in a bind.
Yeah.
That thing will start bucking. Whip you all over the place. Next thing you know, you didn't get messed around and got hurt.
Uh-huh.
And I'm here to tell you, you see, that's a message spiritual.
Yes, Lord. Jesus. Amen.
Now see, you're trying to give people more than they can handle.
Yeah. Preach it, Pastor.
Oh,
yeah. Amen. Uh-huh.
When you give it to God, you can give it all to,
him.
Right. You're trying to give them this and that. Yeah. Whenever they start, that's when you start saying, oh, no.
Yes.
That's when you start, look, your discernment, you should start looking
Amen.
At them.
Amen.
I'm going to have to take the rest of that home.
Yeah,
Because if I put any more down for that sister right there, she going to befriend me. They're not going to know my name. They're going to be way over here. Because people can't handle more than just a little bit. And I'm saying that for us to be encouraged because, you know what, we should be giving everything to the Lord anyway. Why would we want somebody to carry something that we can barely carry
ourselves? Amen.
I'm going to kind of help out the brothers and the sisters who try to help the brother carry and help the sister because we bear each other burden.
Uh-huh.
But let me let you know something. They're not Superman.
Amen. Amen.
They're not Superwoman. You put too much on people.
Yeah.
Come on. You got to wait a minute. You got to be able to. They can only help you with what they can.
Amen.
Because you keep putting more and more on them. You know what? The Lord God's like, you know what? You need to be able to back up and say, you know what? You need to give that to the Lord.
Amen, amen.
Because he can care. He said, who do you think I get my problems to?
Yes,
I know you don't think I'm calling some hotline.
Yes.
I'm calling Jesus.
Amen.
J-E-S-U-S. 24 hours a day,
amen.
7 days a week, 365
amen.
Days in a year.
Yes, Lord.
He always picks up and he's there all the time.
Amen. Oh, yes, Lord.
He's always awake in his watchtower.
Yes,
I
Lord.
I decided to get him at 12:08. He's hello.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, my God.
Yes, Lord.
I mean, I tell you, but the Lord God's saying that whenever he makes a way, he is a way maker. The Bible tells us clearly that he said there's a path that through the mighty water, God says, I'm going to make a pathway. I don't know if you ever had God to make a way in impossible situations,
right.
But that's what the word of the Lord God is saying today. For he's a way maker. He's yes. about to make a pathway where there was no way.
Jesus.
You know, it's one thing to have a pathway that somebody else is trapped.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Preach it, Pastor.
I see that. Well, you can kind of see the grass.
Uh-huh.
You can follow that.
Amen.
But how about a pathway with this? No more.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus. Well, you're the trailblazer.
Amen. Oh, amen.
You're the first one in the family.
Yes, Lord.
Hey!
Yes.
Hey! You're the first one.
Yes,
you know,
Lord.
I can't follow my brother, my sister, because they don't have the testimony.
Amen. Amen.
I can't follow it. But look, I said, you're the first one.
Jesus.
Sold out for Jesus completely. No,
amen. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
For real. For real. You're the first one that believed in God for a miracle. For real.
Yeah. Amen.
They got a lot of people. Oh, yeah, I touched God for a meal. Give them 5 minutes. You see. Put a little weight on them. Woo, God. And they're going to date up. Well, I just couldn't wait. I helped God out. But then yet, there's some of you that are still sitting here and you're waiting.
Oh, Jesus.
You're like, what are you waiting for?
Yeah.
The Lord.
Yes.
And they're looking at you like, you're
yes.
still.
Yes.
Yes.
Preach it, Pastor.
See, that's how you know
amen.
That
amen.
One of those that God says, I'm going to make you a pathway.
Amen.
You need to be encouraged
thank
in
you,
that. Those of you that have decided that I'm going to
wait. Still
waiting. You know what? And waiting means that you continue to do
yes,
what God
Lord.
Told you
amen.
To do before
yes.
he told you to wait.
Yes, yes Lord. Yes, Lord.
He said, when he tell you to wait, that means to continue to do what he told you to do before he told you to wait.
Yes, Lord.
So that means waiting means that you're always moving.
Amen, amen.
Hallelujah. I said that many times, many, many times.
Yes, Lord.
People get waiting, confused, but don't do nothing.
Yes, Lord.
Oh. Go out to eat and have a waiter sit down with you.
Mm.
My God. You're going to wonder what's going on.
Yes, Lord.
You're going to say, I want a tea. They're going to say, me too.
Yes.
Is that not a problem? Uh-huh. You say you wait, you're going to a fancy place. And you're waiting, and you're waiting. Waitress come up and they say, my name is. And you're like, well, bless God. And you say, well, you know, thank you. And then you say, well, you know, I'd like a tea. And they sit down, me too. Maybe you would be a little upset with that.
Amen. Amen.
You're like, oh, my God. You know, things falling down. Then when they get really bold, somebody else needs something. You mind getting that?
Right,
and you reach for the silverware from the other table so I can. You're going a little too far. But see, we think like that whenever we're talking about waiting on God. just supposed to sit there.
No.
You're supposed to be doing something. You're supposed to be busy about the Father's business. You know, just because you ain't got the aunt, just because you don't have the spouse yet, that don't mean you can't pray.
Yes.
All right, now, well, Lord, I'm lonely. But the Lord God said, I will be your husband.
Yes.
Hey.
Yes, Lord.
And you're like, well, Pastor, you say that because you have one. Yeah, there was a season, chair.
Amen. Amen.
We weren't joined at the hip from birth.
Amen. Yes, Lord. Amen.
Yes, Lord. You can say that.
Yes, Lord.
And I can say that in right because whenever we go individually.
Yes, Lord.
Come on now.
Yes.
We gotta ask the Lord single.
Yes.
You know, we're not gonna combine that as far as man. But when the Lord called me, He gonna call me
by myself.
Amen.
All by myself. The Lord God said, "What you was doing?"
Yes, Lord.
You know, while I was waiting on my husband. Come on now. Out today, amen.
Uh-huh.
You see, preach your best.
Preach your best.
Yes, Lord. Because I got my husband. Right. You, so.
Yes,
my
Lord.
You got a marriage. You ain't going to wait on him. What you waiting on him? You need to be about the Father, man. You ain't waiting on him.
Yes, Lord.
Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. Yeah. Right there. But the Lord God said, you know, we can't just continuously just sit there and do nothing. Yeah. The Lord God is trying to tell you that He's going to make a way, a path. Somebody, you need to get that. Yeah. There's not a pathway that God is going to make means that there's nobody else who has it like that before.
Yeah. Amen.
No one else. You know what? That's the problem with some of us. We're so used to seeing other people's miracles, we want it like theirs.
Mm. Uh-huh. Preach it, Pastor. Uh-huh.
No, you know what, Lord? If you're going to heal me that way, heal me the way you want to heal me.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You're going to heal me in the bedroom?
Yes, Lord. Amen.
You're going to heal me in the hospital?
Amen.
Come on up here.
Yes, Lord.
You're going to heal me in the doctor's office?
Yes, Lord.
Step back up and do it. However
you want to do it.
I take the limits off. However you want to do it. You want to do it today? I would love it right about now.
Yes, Lord.
But whatever you want to do, I wanted to make sure that it's your method, your style. Your method, your style. I want you to understand that the Lord God is speaking to our hearts today. And He's trying to tell you that He is going to make a way. As you go a little bit further down, look at verse number 18. The word of the Lord God said, "Do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing."
Lord,
my God. You know what? Yeah, you know, the Lord God, He doesn't want you to remember the former thing. You know what? It's amazing to me. People can remember so much of the bad. Oh, my God.
Preach it, Pastor. Preach it.
You do 10 good things, one bad thing. You know what they bring up? The bad thing. You're like, my God, what did we do? I think it was a moment. Yes. I had a moment. Tell your neighbor, I had a moment. But the moment something comes up, that's the word. They, out of all the things they can grab, they can't grab that you stayed up praying for. They can't grab that you loved all of them. Even what? They can't grasp that all that you've done. But the one weak moment, remember that?
Yeah. Right.
It's like you pull the cobwebs off of that. Where did you get that one from? I don't even remember that. My name wasn't my name. I wasn't a woman of God.
Amen, amen.
You don't remember that. You're going fishing way back there.
Preach it, Pastor.
Back there.
Yeah.
The Lord God is trying to tell, and I said, it's amazing how the Spirit of the Lord utilized the prophet Isaiah. Because when He used the prophet Isaiah, he said, don't remember the former things, but then not consider the things of old. When He says that, but He does want you to remember the victories.
Okay.
Yeah. He's trying to tell you, don't remember that old stuff. Tell your neighbor, old stuff.
Old stuff.
The Lord God is trying to tell you, don't remember that old stuff. The bad that I've done. The wrong that I've said. You know what? Thank God that's covered by grace and mercy. Fresh and new every day. I open up a fresh one today. Somebody better get that mantle. Fresh! Right off the bakery.
Fresh.
Because I wore mine out.
Thank you, Lord God.
Thank you for that.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, my God. By the time midnight, I was running on crumbs.
Yes, Lord.
1201, bless the Lord. I got a fresh.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm just keeping it nice and raw up in here.
Yeah.
See, I'm not going to stand before you and tell you that I live in a glass house. And you know what? No. I live in a glass house, so I don't throw no stone.
That's right.
Amen.
Because whenever you start throwing one, 10 come back.